Hello, you have just seen the Korg Nano Control 2 with my nanometer script for FL Studio. It began as an experiment script I wrote to explore ImageLine's new script API. I think it turned out pretty well, so I decided to make it into something that everyone can use. Nano Control 2 is a relatively cheap MIDI controller with transport controls, a bunch of knobs and sliders, and a couple of rows of solo and mute buttons with lights. As you saw in the intro, the script uses the lights on the Nano Control 2 to display the peak meter in FL Studio. The two rows represent the peaks of the left and right stereo signal. The script automatically detects if the signal changes to mono and will display this by switching to a single light row. Or, if you want, you can also replace the stereo and mono peak meters with one big peak meter that utilizes all three light rows. The peaks can also be set to follow the selected track in the mixer instead of the master track. Nanometer also detects clipping of the sound signal and will indicate this by keeping the last button of the light row where the clipping occurred lit for approximately 2 to 3 seconds. Next, we have the transport buttons. They work like you expect. The stop button doubles as the pattern song switch by simply holding it down for more than 1 second. When recording, the record button will flash in sync with the current tempo. You can also quick save the current project in FL Studio by holding down Cycle and pressing Record. The button will flash a few times to indicate that your project was saved. The default control mode in Nanometer is the mixer mode. There are 8 control groups on the Nano Control 2 that gives you control over 8 tracks in the mixer. The sliders and knobs controls the volume and panning. The solo and mute buttons can of course be used to solo or mute tracks and will also show whether a track is soloed or muted by its light indicator. The R buttons are by default used to select individual tracks. You can also select the previous or next track by pressing the track arrow buttons. The green tracks are colored automatically by the script to highlight the tracks you can control and thereby making them easier to locate. While you can only control up to 8 tracks at a time, you can shift the control tracks by one track to either the left or the right by pressing the marker arrow buttons. This effectively gives you full control of all the tracks in the mixer. You may also move the whole group at once by simply selecting a track anywhere in the mixer and pressing the Set Marker button. The highlighted tracks will then instantly be relocated to the track you selected. To prevent the need for moving the highlighted tracks around every time you need to take control of the master track, it can be split off from the rest of the tracks and controlled separately. Next up, we have the channel rack control mode. To be able to control the channel rack, you must first switch away from the mixer control mode by pressing the cycle button. Notice how the channel rack window came into focus. The marker arrow buttons will step between the channels in the channel rack. Press the Set Marker button to bring up the plugin window of the selected channel. Pressing it again will close the window. The leftmost solo and mute buttons will solo and mute the selected channel. They will also light up to indicate whether the current channel is soloed or muted. The channel mixer routing can also be changed by slowly turning the leftmost knob. Next, we'll go over the functions in the playlist mode. Press the cycle button to switch mode. The playlist window now becomes focused. Use the track arrow buttons to step between patterns. The set marker button will open up the piano roll for the current pattern. Press it again to close the piano roll and return to the playlist window. You can jump between markers in your project by pressing the marker arrow buttons. Add or remove markers by holding down the cycle button and pressing set marker. How about zooming? Just move the first slider to zoom in and out horizontally and the second slider to zoom vertically. Or why not both at the same time? You may also change the current tempo by turning the leftmost knob. Last but not least, let's take a look at the config file. The Nanometer script has a bunch of options that can be changed to your liking by just making a few changes in the accompanying file called config.py that came with the main script. Open config.py in a text editor. I'm using Notepad++ here, but you can use any editor you like. Let's look at the armed tracks option. This option is used by the script to change what the R buttons do. By default, the R buttons are used for selecting individual tracks. Let's activate arm tracks by setting the option to true. Save the file and restart the script. The R buttons are now set up to arm tracks instead of selecting them. To learn more about the config options, visit the Nanometer wiki page. And that's it for this presentation. I hope you find my script useful. If you have any questions, please leave a comment on ImageLine's MIDI scripting forum in the Nanometer topic. Thanks for watching!